गुड इवनिंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू एम्स इंडिया ऑनलाइन सेशन न्यूट्रिशन द फूड सप्लाइंग सिस्टम पार्ट फोर. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड द डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस, दैट इज लाइट रिएक्शन, डार्क रिएक्शन, एंड वी एंटर इनटू द हेटरोट्रोफिक न्यूट्रिशन, पर्टिकुलरली होलोजोइक न्यूट्रिशन. इन दैट nutrition in human beings, the complex organisms, in simple organisms like amoeba and paramecium, there is a food vacuole where the digestion takes place, but in the human beings the complex separate system is present for the nutrition. It is called the digestive system. The organs of digestive system work together to perform digestion function. The total digestive system is divided into alimentary canal and associated glands. Okay, so the alimentary canal consisting of mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, and last part is anus. Okay, and the digestive glands include salivary glands, liver, pancreas, intestinal glands. So let us proceed today's class. Human digestive system and how the food start digestion. The passage of food through alimentary canal or gut. As soon as the ingestion process, what are the steps involved in the digestion? In the complex organisms, the total nutrition in the complex organisms can be studied under different headings like ingestion, taking in of food, then the second step we are in digestion, and the third step is after digestion absorption, and the fourth step is assimilation, and the last step is digestion. So we are in the second step, digestion. So the passage of food through alimentary canal or gut. The food is cut and crushed by our teeth. You know, variety of teeth are present in our mouth. What are the teeth? Just recall: canines, incisors, canines, premolars, and molars. Four types of teeth performing different functions. So with the help of teeth, the food is cut and crushed into pieces. So this process is called as mastication. This process is called mastication. So the mastication of the food takes place in the mouth, and the mouth also consisting of salivary glands which secrete saliva. The food mixes with saliva to make it wet and slippery. So this wet and slippery food is acted upon by enzyme called thiamine in the saliva. Saliva is secreted by three pairs of salivary glands. It mainly contains an enzyme amylase or salivary amylase. It is also called thiamine. What is the function of thiamine? Thiamine helps in the breaking of starch, which is complex into dextrins and maltose sugar. Dextrins and maltose sugar, which are simple, means partial digestion of the food material taking place in the mouth, or the digestion of food starts in the mouth itself. Okay, mouth or oral cavity. In the oral cavity there is a tongue, teeth, and a space called oral cavity or buccal cavity, in which three pairs of salivary glands are present: sublingual, submandibular, and parotid glands. Okay, like this. So parotid glands nearby ear. Okay, these parotid glands are present. So sublingual, the lower jaw beneath the tongue, and beside it only submandibular glands. So these glands secrete saliva. The saliva contains an enzyme called thiamine. The partially digested food in the mouth is called bolus, B-O-L-U-S. The partly digested food in the mouth is called bolus. Okay, remember children the technical term. Next part, oesophagus. So in the oesophagus, the soft food which is formed in the mouth, the food mixes with the saliva, passes through oesophagus, or it is also called as a food pipe. By means of wave-like motion or movement, which is called peristaltic movement or peristalsis, the food is pushed into the stomach. So there is no special digestive enzymes are secreted in the oesophagus. The already started digestion process in the mouth will continue in the oesophagus. So only the digestion of starch, that is a complex food, is converted into dextrins and maltose by the action of ptyalene, continue in the oesophagus. So this is the oesophagus. It is also called as a food pipe. It is also called a food pipe. So by means of contraction and relaxation, the smooth muscles are present in this food pipe. So by contraction and relaxation, a wave-like motion is produced like this. So the food present in this will push it to the next organ, that is a stomach. Okay. From the oesophagus, the food enters into the stomach. Slowly, the food undergo physical and chemical changes. Because what is digestion? Digestion is nothing but the process of breaking down of complex food molecules into the simplest food molecules is called digestion. This process involves the physical and chemical changes. So physical means by means of churning, by means of the movements of these muscular actions will help the food to undergo lot of changes. That's why the food, whenever you are eating, you must chew the food thoroughly so that our digestive system will get some rest, means some load on the digestive system will be decreased. So after thorough chewing, then only you will enjoy the taste of the food with the saliva. Okay, when it thoroughly mixes with the saliva, then that bolus will enter into the next part, that is stomach. Okay, so what is that movement, wave-like movement? Peristalsis or peristaltic movement. Next, digestion in the stomach. Digestion of food in the stomach. The food gets churned in the churned with gastric juice. The digestive juice secreted by the stomach is called gastric juice. It is a mixture of enzymes and hydrochloric acid, HCl. Now the food is in semi-solid condition. So the digestion in the stomach, you know, the stomach is a big muscular bag-like structure where the food is stored temporarily, and the food undergo the physical and chemical change in the stomach. There are different types of muscles present in the stomach which are arranged in a different manner. Longitudinal muscles, circular muscles, diagonal muscles. Like that, the different muscles, they contract and relax and involve in a process called churning. The food gets thoroughly mixes with this gastric juice and HCl. The gastric juice containing some enzymes. The main enzyme which digests the proteins is gastric pepsin or pepsin. Actually, this pepsin is produced in inactive form, pepsinogen. The HCl converts the pepsinogen into pepsin. Hydrochloric acid will act on the pepsinogen and converts into active form pepsin. Because these enzymes, digestive enzymes, they have they are active only at a specific pH. Some of the enzymes are active in the acidic medium, some of the enzymes are active in the alkaline or basic medium. So for the action of pepsin enzyme, some acidic medium is required, that is provided by the hydrochloric acid present in the gastric juice. Okay, children. Next, this the digestion of proteins are broken down into smaller molecules with the help of an enzyme pepsin acting on those proteins. The partially digested food in the stomach is called chyme. So previously, the partially digested food in the mouth, we call it as a bolus. Now another term, chyme. Chyme is acidic in nature. The partially digested food in the stomach is called chyme. The acidic chyme from stomach passes into the small intestine through pyloric sphincter. A valve is present near the end of the stomach. The stomach is divided into two parts, cardiac stomach and pyloric stomach. Pyloric stomach means the end of the stomach where a valve is present, that is called pyloric sphincter. Pyloric sphincter. What this pyloric sphincter do is, it regulates, it allows only small amount of food to enter into the duodenum, because the food is stored for nearly 2 to 3 hours in the stomach. Okay, it undergo physical and chemical changes, and here the sphincter muscles are present, pyloric sphincter. So slowly it allows small amount of food to enter into duodenum, the first part of small intestine. Okay, so this is about the digestion of food in the stomach. Only one enzyme mainly, what is that? Actually, the gastric juice consisting of pepsin, gastric lipase, these are the two main enzymes. Along with that, hydrochloric acid is present. So hydrochloric acid provides the acidic medium for the action of this pepsin enzyme. The pepsin enzyme acts on the proteins and break them into peptones and polypeptides. Okay, so proteins are complex compared to carbohydrates. So let us proceed. Digestion in the small intestine, that is duodenum. In the first part, the major portion of digestion takes place in the duodenum of small intestine. Small intestine is the longest part of alimentary canal. It is the site of further digestion of carbohydrates, proteins and fats. It receives the secretions of liver and pancreas. It receives the secretions of liver and pancreas. These juices render the internal conditions of the intestine gradually to the basic or alkaline, because the chyme, which is acidic because of presence of the hydrochloric acid. So in order to undergo the further digestion process, the medium of that food material must be changed into alkaline. It must be neutralized. So some salts are added present in the bile juice, like sodium chelate and sodium deoxycholate. So the secretions of liver and pancreas are added to the duodenum like this. So liver is the largest gland in the body. It is the largest organ, very important organ. It is often called as the factory of the human body, which performs more than 100 functions. So one of the function is secretion of bile juice. The bile juice is very important. So this bile does not contain any digestive enzymes. It is the only digestive juice which does not contain any digestive enzymes, but it contains the pigments and some salts. The bile salts play very important role in emulsification of fats. For the digestion of fats, the fats are more complex substances than proteins. So in order to digest the fats will undergo a process called emulsification, where these bile salts act on the fats and convert them into microcolloidal substances, small substances. Then only the action of lipase enzyme on the fats takes place. So the bile juice produced by hepatic cells or liver cells, so these bile juice passes into the gallbladder. Gallbladder is a sac-like structure which concentrates the bile. It absorbs the water, excess water present in the bile, and makes it concentrated. From the gallbladder, the bile enters into the duodenum by means of cystic duct, a common duct. Bile duct from liver through bile duct, the bile juice passes into the gallbladder. From the gallbladder, by means of a common duct called cystic duct, it opens into the duodenum. This is the duodenum, the first part of the small intestine. Then next, the pancreas. Pancreas is a pale yellow color gland, digestive gland present beneath the stomach or below the stomach. So this is also very important gland, which plays a very important role. It is a mixed gland in the body, performs both exocrine and endocrine. So digestive glands are exocrine because they release their secretions directly into the digestive organs by means of ducts. Okay, ducted glands, exocrine in function. Ductless glands are called endocrine glands. Okay, we'll study further in the next topics. Okay, so pancreas produces a digestive juice called pancreatic juice. This pancreatic juice contains several enzymes, and these pancreatic juice, the pancreatic juice enters into duodenum through common duct, pancreatic duct, pancreatic duct, bile duct. Okay, so salivary duct, saliva, opens into this esophagus, and this gastric juice, then after digestion, here pyloric sphincter is present, okay, which allows small amount of food. And the maximum part of digestion takes place in the duodenum, or the digestion will completes in the duodenum part maximum, then in the ileum total digestion completes. Okay, let us proceed. So here once again let us recall the different digestive glands. Salivary glands present in the mouth secrete saliva containing enzyme ptyalin or salivary amylase. Esophagus, there is no digestion in the esophagus, only the food passes, wave like motion takes place, that is called peristalsis, and opens into the stomach. The stomach contains gastric glands which secrete gastric juice. Okay, so the gastric juice enters into the stomach, and in the stomach there are several muscles are present. Physical and chemical changes of the food takes place in the stomach. Churning of food takes place. Then the liver. Liver is a digestive gland, largest gland, which is secretes bile juice. The bile juice opens into gallbladder by means of bile duct. In the gallbladder, bile juice gets concentrated and opens into duodenum by means of a common duct, cystic duct. Okay, the pancreas is a digestive gland. This pancreas secrete pancreatic juice which opens into duodenum, and the duodenum is the first part of small intestine. There are three parts are there in the small intestine: duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Ileum is the most coiled part where the total digestion finish, and absorption of the food also takes place in this ileum of the small intestine. by means of special structures called villi. What are the villi? Villi are finger-like projections present in the ileum of the small intestine, which are richly supplied with blood capillaries and which absorb the digested food materials. So here appendicitis or appendix is a rudimentary organ. It is not involving or not participating in any part of digestion of the food. Okay. It is a vestigial organ. Then large intestine. The large intestine is divided into colon and colon, cecum and rectum. Okay. Colon, cecum, rectum. The rectum is the terminal part of the large intestine, which opens into anus. So once again, you see here, liver produces or secretes bile juice, which does not contain any enzyme. So this bile juice enters into the gallbladder first. So by means of bile duct, the gallbladder stores the bile, which aids in digesting the lipids. So the bile juice containing water, bile salts. The bile salts will involve in the emulsification of fats, indirectly help in the digestion of fats. Then a common duct, I told. What is that duct? Common duct called cystic duct. The bile duct opens into the duodenum. So this is the mid lumen of the duodenum. The pancreatic duct will release pancreatic juice. Then early part of the small intestine, duodenum, that is, the pancreas produce digestive enzymes and bicarbonate solution. This is very important, okay, because HCl is present, acid plus salt, okay, and water, it mixes thoroughly, and the alkaline medium is produced for the action of the enzymes present in the pancreatic juice and the gastric juice. Okay, so this is a brief explanation of the digestive system and the process of digestion. So let us proceed to how the enzymes act. So here one table is given, so you please note down, if time allows you, please note down. There are three columns are given: active site, enzyme, and the effect on the food. The active site, mouth. In the mouth, saliva contains salivary amylase. It is also called as a ptyalin. Salivary amylase is also called a ptyalin. So it breaks down starches into disaccharides. Already mentioned, what are they? Maltose and dextrins. Starch is converted. Starch is a polysaccharide, which is breakdown into maltose and dextrins. They are disaccharides, means more than or one unit of. If one unit of glucose is present, it is monosaccharide. If two units of glucose are present, they are called disaccharides. Okay. Saccharides means sugars. Next, stomach. Stomach is the active site. The enzyme present in the stomach, main enzyme, pepsin. What is the enzyme present in the stomach? Pepsin. The pepsin acts on proteins and converted into large peptides. Okay. Polypeptides and peptides. What is digestion means? The complex organic substances, the bonds are present. Chemical bonds. So these enzymes will break those bonds so that complex food materials are converted into simplest food materials. So these all the enzymes, digestive enzymes, are hydrolytic enzymes. They break the bonds by adding water molecules. Okay, children. Pepsin acts on proteins and converts into simple. You can write like this. Proteins gives rise to peptides. On the arrow, you can write pepsin. Okay. Next, small intestine. The small intestine from duodenum receives enzymes from the pancreas. The enzymes present in the pancreatic juice are amylase, trypsin, lipase. Here the lipase, you can call it as pancreatic lipase. Okay. Gastric lipase. If the lipase is present in the gastric juice, gastric lipase. Amylase. Amylases are those enzymes which digest the carbohydrates. That continues the breaking of starch, means dextrins and maltose are converted to simpler sugars by amylase enzyme present in the pancreatic juice. Don't think that the digestion takes place in the pancreas. The pancreatic juice enters into the duodenum, where in the small intestine, the duodenum only, the active site, that's why here mentioned small intestine. From pancreas, these are the enzymes released into the small intestine. This is the action or effect on the food. Next, trypsin. Trypsin continues the breakdown of proteins. Means, from on the peptides, these trypsin will act and converted into polypeptides, and peptones are formed. Okay, you have to mention proteins. Partly digested proteins or peptides gives rise to peptones by the action of trypsin. On the arrow mark, trypsin. Lipase. Lipase acts on fats. Here you have to mention emulsified fats. The fats are already emulsified by bile salts present in the bile juice. So converted into fatty acids and glycerol. Fatty acids and glycerol. The next, small intestine. The enzymes released by the small intestine, the digestive juice is called as succus entericus. S-U-C-C-U-S. Succus entericus. E-N-T-E-R-I-C-U-S. Succus entericus is the enzymes present in the intestinal juice is called succus entericus. It contains group of enzymes. Maltase, sucrase, lactase, peptidase, like the different enzymes are present. They act on different substrates. What are the substrates? Maltase acts on maltose. Maltose is a disaccharide and converted into glucose. Sucrase acts on sucrose. You write down maltase. So first, maltose you have to write, gives rise to glucose. On the arrow mark, maltase. Then sucrose, S-U-C-R-O-S-E, sucrose, gives rise to glucose. On the arrow mark, sucrase. Lactose, milk sugar. Okay? Lactose gives rise to. On the arrow mark, lactase gives rise to glucose. Like this, peptidase, enzyme which digests the peptides. Peptides and peptones gives rise to amino acids. What are the end products of proteins digestion? Amino acids. Okay. And nucleases are the enzymes present in the succus entericus. They digest the, okay, nucleic acids like that. The total digestion process completes in the small intestine. Okay, what are the end products? All carbohydrates are converted to glucose. All proteins are converted to amino acids. All fats are converted to fatty acids and glycerol. These are the end products of digestion. Okay, then absorption takes place. The absorption takes place in the small intestine. Villi are the structures which absorb the digested food materials or the products of digestion and opens into the blood. The blood carries the digested food materials to all cells of the body. Okay. And it is assimilated in the releasing energy. Okay. Energy is produced in the process of assimilation. In the mitochondria of the cell, that energy is produced. Okay. So one flow chart, how the digestive system follows. The food taken into mouth. From the mouth or in the mouth, buccal cavity or oral cavity, the process of digestion begins, and the bolus is formed in the mouth. That bolus is passed into pharynx. There is no digestion. That is continuation of the action of ptyalin on the starch continues in the pharynx as well as in the oesophagus. Next, oesophagus. From the oesophagus, here peristalsis movement peristalsis movement takes place, the wave-like movement, peristalsis, and through peristalsis the food enters into the first part of the stomach called cardiac stomach, which is close to the heart, cardiac stomach. Then from that the food enters into pyloric stomach, where pyloric sphincter is present. The small amount of food from the stomach, the partly digested food in the stomach is called chyme. So that chyme slowly enters into the duodenum through pyloric sphincter. Here valve is present, pyloric sphincter. Then the duodenum is the first part of the small intestine. The duodenum receives enzymes or digestive juices from bile juice and bile juice from the liver, and pancreatic juice from the pancreas enters into duodenum. In the duodenum, the digestion continues. The food turns into alkaline by means of the salts present in the pancreatic juice. Then the food enters into the further small intestine from the duodenum, jejunum and ileum of the small intestine. The process of digestion completes. Then the food enters into large intestine. The food containing water, the undigested food containing water, is absorbed in the large intestine. Then the undigested food enters into the rectum, where it gets concentrated and opens out through anus. That process is called as defecation. Undigested food, elimination of undigested food is called egestion or defecation. This is the flowchart representing the human digestive system and the process of digestion. Okay, children. So let us test ourselves. Today's quiz number 4. Which of the following glands are associated with elementary canal? Salivary gland, liver, pancreas. So your answer is all of the above. Saliva, bile juice, pancreatic juice are produced by these glands. Next. Dash is the process by which the food moves forward in the elementary canal. What is that process? Wave-like motion. The wave-like motion of the oesophagus, what is it called? Peristalsis. Option B. Next. What is observed? Water is observed from the undigested food material in which part of the elementary canal? Small intestine, large intestine, liver, rectum. So where the water is observed? Large intestine. Okay. Next. On treating starch with saliva, it gets break down to form maltose, fatty acids, sucrose, amino acids. What is the correct answer? On treating with saliva, it gets break down into maltose sugar. Starch is converted into maltose and dextrose. Okay, it is a disaccharide. A is the correct answer. Next, dash secrete bile, which is temporarily stored in a sac called, here two options, means two answers, which will secrete bile and in which the bile is stored temporarily. Pancreas and stomach, liver and stomach, liver and gallbladder, small intestine and gallbladder. What is the correct answer, children? You're right. Liver and gallbladder. Liver secretes bile and it is stored temporarily in the sac called gallbladder. Next, which of the following glands is located just below the stomach? A. Liver, B. Gallbladder, C. Pancreas, D. Rectum. Which of the following glands is located just below the stomach? Yellow color gland, what is that? Yes, pancreas. C is the correct answer. Pancreas is a mixed gland. Next, the process in which absorbed food is taken in by body cells. What is that step? Absorption, digestion, assimilation, adhesion. Absorbed food is taken in by body cells. It is called assimilation. Assimilation. Okay, this is the fourth step. Next. Largest gland in the human body is liver, pancreas, parotid glands, oesophagus. What is the right answer? Liver. Okay, A is the correct answer. Next, bile helps in breakdown of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins. As we know that bile juice does not contain any digestive enzymes, but it involves in the process of digestion, the bile salts. Okay, what is that process? Emulsification. Emulsification of which substrate? So it is very important, children. Substrate, enzyme, products. Three columns you have to make. The substrate is carbohydrate, proteins, fats, lipids, and the enzymes. Okay, what are the enzymes? Amylases act on proteins. Proteases act on proteins. Lipases act on fats. And what are the products? Carbohydrates converted to glucose, proteins converted to amino acids, fats converted to fatty acids and glycerol. So here the bile helps in the breakdown of fats. C. What is that process? Emulsification of fats. Next. Which of the following is not digested by human beings? In our digestive system, one of the substrate is not digested. What is that substrate? You studied in 7th class itself. Fats, proteins, starch, cellulose. Okay, what is that, children? Cellulose is the polysaccharide which is not digested by human digestive system. It is present in the plant food materials, cellulose. To digest the cellulose, what is required? Cellulase enzyme is required, which is not produced in our digestive system. That's why these ruminants digestive system, that cellulase is produced by the intestinal bacteria and flagellated protozoans. Symbiotic association is there in those animals. Okay, but in human digestive system, cellulose is not digested. It is present in the undigested food materials and eliminated out. Next, the enzyme present in gastric juice which digests proteins is, the enzyme present in the gastric juice which digests the proteins is, what is that only enzyme present in the gastric juice which digests the proteins? Pepsin. Okay, pepsin. The last question of the day. The enzyme present in the salivary juice which partially digests the starch is, what is that? Ptyalin. Okay, it is also called salivary amylase. So children, the enzymes are not produced in their active forms, like pepsin in the form of pepsinogen, trypsin in the form of trypsinogen, and chymotrypsin in the form of chymotrypsinogen. So gen, the prefix and suffix will be there, end of the enzyme. If gen is present, means it is an inactive enzyme. So in the digestive system, some substances are produced which activate these enzymes. That is, for example, the pepsin is activated by HCl, act on pepsinogen and converts into pepsin. But the trypsinogen is converted to trypsin by another enzyme, intestinal enzyme, that is called enterokinase. Enterokinase is an enzyme which converts the trypsinogen and chymotrypsinogen into active trypsin and chymotrypsin. Okay, so children, I hope you are following. So the total lesson is divided into 5 parts only, so I included more, so trying to explain you. If textbooks are available, you please read the textbook so that you can get complete clarity. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.